Hello friends, I am Rahul and welcome to my channel Let's Talk Embedded, where we can learn various topics and technologies related to embedded systems. In this video, I will be demonstrating how we can set up Visual Studio Code for Arduino platform. That means we will be using Visual Studio Code as an alternative to Arduino IDE. What is an IDE? An IDE or Integrated Development Environment enables programmers to consolidate the different aspects of writing a computer program. IDE increases a programmer productivity by combining common activities of writing a software into a single application. Some of the activities are editing source code, building an executables, creating artifacts for the target board, debugging and testing. Why Visual Studio Code? Visual Studio Code offers a lot of advantage over the other integrated development environment tools like the Arduino IDE. It has a lot of features like IntelliSense, which helps the user to highlight the syntax, and it will also suggest the smart completion based on variable types, function definitions and imported modules. It offers extensive debugging techniques like the breakpoints, call stacks and interactive console that will be very efficient and helpful to debug certain issues. It offers the git command built-in functionality where we can use git to source code management, and it will be helpful for efficiently version control your software. It is extensible and customizable. That means we can install a lot of extensions so that it will be a single stop solutions for multiple product development environments. It offers a lot of languages like Java, JavaScript, Python, C, C++, PHP, C#, HTML, PowerShell, JSON, and so on. And this is why this is a very effective tool for develop. So here I have downloaded Visual Studio Code, and this is how it looks like after some initial configurations. The board I'm using is the Arduino Mega 2560 revision 3. So this is how the board looks like. It has this USB connector and this is the power jack connector. So I'll be using USB connector to give the power to this board as well as to communicate between my Arduino board and laptop. So couple of things we can see here is the power tree. So we can basically give the power like 5 volt supply using the USB cable, or the 12 volt supply using the power jack connector. So you can note that when you use a 12 volt, we can produce or we can source more current to the board, or when we use the 5 volt supply, it depends on either you're giving through this regulator. It supports up to 160 milliamps, and if you are giving through your laptop, then your current limitations is based on your laptop USB port. So some of the applications like driving the loads or LEDs and motors required more current. So before using the power supply, you can see what are your applications are. But for our need, we'll be using the 5 volt supply, which is sufficient for our demonstration. So let's create a small project to print the characters on the serial port using VS Code. So when you open the VS Code, you go to the Explorer window in the activity bar. You have to add the folder here, your project folder. So let's add. I'll click on the open folder. So here I need to create a new folder. So I'll go to the Arduino and I'll create a new folder here. That is VS Code. You can select this as a project folder. So when you add the project folder, it will populate all the project files. In Arduino, the files are all always named as .ino extension, and they call it as a sketches. So right now there are no sketches here. So let's create one file here. So add, click on the new file. So we can create the file name as a VS code, let's say, and always give the extension as a .ino. This is how the Arduino will recognize this as the Arduino sketch. Now this file is empty, so let's add some code here. For that, what I will do is I will go to the Arduino IDE, which is already open here, and I will maybe open some example code under the basics. I will go to the bare minimum code. It will open another window with that new sketch. Okay, so I'm going to copy these two functions from this bare minimum code to my new VS Code file. So you can note that there are two functions, a setup where you can put a setup code here that will run once when you start your application on the target board. Then the loop function will be continuously or repeatedly run by the Arduino board. So whatever the logic you have to add, which you want to repeatedly execute, you can add in the loop. So let's add a setup. So here we will add the serial port configuration. So serial.begin. Need to add the baud rate for the serial port. And then in the loop, I want to print some string, let's say. So for that I will add serial dot print line, that is print ln, and I will add my string that I want print, let's say hello VS code. Okay, and I'll give some delay here, let's say 1 second delay, so that strings will not be printed continuously. Okay, so this is now the bare minimum code that we want to flash into the Arduino board, but we cannot see anything here that we can use to flash any shortcuts. So for that we need to install Arduino extension. So how we're going to install, go to the extension and search for the Arduino. You'll probably see a bunch of options. Let's check the first option. Yep, this is what we want. So this is the extension from the Microsoft, and there's some prerequisites for this extension to work in a Visual Studio Code environment. What are those? First of all, we have to have this Arduino IDE installed. Either we need this Arduino IDE or we need the Arduino command line interface. So I already have the Arduino IDE, so I'm okay with the prerequisites. So let's go ahead and install this extension. All right, once so I have my Arduino extension installed. When the extension is installed, you can see here some shortcuts appear when you install the Arduino IDE, and you can also see some of the lines are underlined with the red, so there might be some problems. So Let's fix that. So what are the shortcuts we see here? So these are typical shortcuts that we can also see in the Arduino IDE, that we can verify the code. That is, we can compile the code, then we can upload the code into the Arduino target with this shortcuts, and this is run or debug shortcut. Let's verify the code. Now hit verify icon. It's giving me an error. Please select board type first. So you can select the board type from here, or you can go to the you can type Control Shift P, and you can write Arduino command. So it will give all the commands supported for the Arduino extension. So you can click on the change board type. It will populate all the board type options for the Arduino platform. So I'll select the Mega or Mega 2560 board. Once I select, you can see here the board type is changed. You can again change from either here or from Control Shift P shortcut. Okay, let's go to verify again. Okay, now it's verifying the code. All right, so it has completed the verification. Now we can try to program this code to the Arduino board. You can also see that the underlined red lines are gone. That means the code is perfectly compiled. So let's go to the shortcut icon, that is Arduino upload. Now it's showing the pop-up that serial port is not specified. So you can either select the serial port from here, from this bottom ribbon, or you can type Control Shift and P. It will give you the pop-up. So now you can again type the Arduino, use a bunch of options. You can see the select serial port. So this is an option. So here I have only one port available, that is COM3. So I will select the COM3 port. We can see the COM3 port is selected here. So let's try to upload the program. Okay, now it's started uploading the program. First, it will verify it again. Okay, so it has completed the uploading. Now, how can we verify whether our program is running or not? So we can verify whether this line hello VS code is getting printed on the serial monitor. So for that, and the output window, we can change the option from Arduino to serial monitor. Now once you go to serial monitor, you have to see a couple of options. One, if the baud rate is set correctly, and if the port is selected properly. So our port I think is selected COM3. So let's check the baud rate. So for that, I will again press Control Shift P, then let's type baud. It will give the option like change baud rate. So I will change the baud rate to 9600. Also have to pick one more option, like open the serial monitor. So let's open the serial monitor, and once you select the COM port, once you select the baud rate, and when you open the serial port, you can see my Arduino board is printing hello VS code. So this is how we have set up the VS code IDE for Arduino board, and henceforward you can start using the Visual Studio Code for your further projects and development. Thank you.